More than 40 million U.S. airline passengers are expected to go through airport security checkpoints this holiday. But this TSA security director says you may not be as safe as you think.
What they're doing is injecting danger into the system.
Jay Brainerd is the top TSA official in his state and has been with the agency for 17 years.
All right.
He says TSA is cutting corners on the screening process to shorten wait times. One example, TSA reduced the sensitivity on all walk-through metal detectors at airports across America.
They are reducing the concentration of metal that it would take to set off that alarm so that you can speed up lines and have fewer pat-downs.
How do you know that's why they did it?
Because there's a memo out that supports it.
This TSA memo shows the order came in 2013, quote, changing all walk-through metal detector settings in all lanes to the TSA pre-check setting to normalize the passenger experience. Brainerd says the practice continues today, and he worries bomb-making components could go undetected.
You could have a 30-minute wait time, and they treat it like it's a national emergency. It is such an unhealthy obsession of placing speed over security.
Brainerd says that obsession also led the TSA to disable technology on X-ray machines that screen carry-on bags in pre-check lanes. This internal memo states as of last month, those X-ray machines should be operated without the auto-detection algorithm enabled.
Put simply, when the item comes through, a box will come around and surround the item. It says, hey, stop and take a look at this. That box is no longer on the screen. TSA has made changes to the settings which really hamper the ability of the X-ray operator to detect explosives and carry-on baggage.
But TSA will say this is pre-check.
They have been putting millions of passengers into TSA pre-check who aren't pre-check. So you do not have an entire population in pre-check that are vetted.
Morning, everybody.
CNN put this to TSA Administrator David Pekoski. He said the agency is not prioritizing wait times over security.
I won't discuss any of our particular security procedures because that's really not appropriate for me to do. But rest assured that we do provide the level of security that we think is appropriate based on the risk of the passenger.
Brainerd says the issues he's raised are especially problematic for an agency with a 95% failure rate in detecting dangerous items at the checkpoint. That's according to a government audit in 2015. Another audit 2 years later found there were still vulnerabilities.
When you sit back and you watch these things happen, it is the most frustrating thing you can imagine.
Going public is his last resort. He's filed an official whistleblower complaint with the Office of Special Counsel. He sent complaints to DHS, TSA, and sent letters to Congress, not just about the metal detectors, but also the X-ray machines. A policy change allowing some passengers with medical devices to do a self-pat-down, and a new policy called blended lanes, where pre-check and standard passengers are mixed in one line, something that could confuse screeners.
They now have to mentally switch themselves on and off about what's permitted, what's not permitted with every other passenger. You know, the last time I checked, our detection rates were not stellar. And it doesn't make any sense to introduce this kind of variable.
Last year, the special counsel ordered DHS to investigate Brainerd's complaints, writing, there is a substantial likelihood that the information provided to OSC discloses gross mismanagement and specific danger to public safety.
My biggest fear is having something happen that costs American lives, and I didn't step up and put a stop to it, or at least try. Because it's going to happen. It's not a question of if, it's a question of when. We are long overdue for another attack.
TSA did take action on one of Brainerd's complaints. He says they continued to use an ineffective test to determine if new hires were colorblind, a disqualifying medical condition, even after concerns about the test's effectiveness were raised.
If you had something in a bag and if somebody were colorblind, they wouldn't see the bomb if it were the only thing in the bag.
TSA is now using a new test for new hires. But according to this TSA memo, the agency will not finish retesting the existing workforce until the end of next year. Brainerd knows, despite whistleblower protections and consistent top ratings on his TSA performance evaluations, speaking out could cost him his job.
And I fully expect that the first discussion that they're going to have is how they can fire me.
But he believes these issues are too urgent to keep quiet.
And to be clear, the changes have not been made to the body scanners that passengers go through. CNN reached out to both agencies, investigated Brainerd's complaints, but no comment from either. Brainerd has a whistleblower attorney. And in response to the complaints he raised in our story, the head of TSA told me that whistleblowers, and I'm quoting, provide a very valuable service, and it's our responsibility to fully investigate those concerns to see if they represent a valid security risk or not. The TSA, though, Wolf saying that they haven't finished that assessment just yet.